गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, अवर सेशन ऑफ SAPM दैट इज सिक्योरिटी एनालिसिस एंड पोर्टफोलियो मैनेजमेंट. नाउ एज फार एज आर प्रीवियस सेशन वॉज कंसर्न, इन दैट वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्सपेक्टेड रिटर्न एंड रिस्क ऑफ अ पोर्टफोलियो, that how a portfolio is going to be beneficial for the particular investment for the diversification of their risk, and they are able to enhance their return in a proper manner. Now basically the concept behind this portfolio return, efficient portfolio return and portfolio risk is given by Markowitz, and it is known as the Markowitz model. Whatever formula we have seen in our last session, it is about the formula of Markowitz model. Now Markowitz gives a proper solution to the investor about how you are able to reduce your risk by holding two security at a time as compared to holding one security at a time. As we already know that the maximum risk is attached when we are going to have our investment only in a single security, but investor can reduce their risk by diversifying its investment into different securities. That is the main benefit of portfolio. In portfolio, investor is going to select the securities in which he founds the maximum benefit as far as the risk perception of the investor. If the investor is risky, if he is a risk taker, then definitely he will select the security which gives maximum risk to the investor, but in the return the investor gets the maximum return. But the investors who is the risk seeker, he will select those securities in which the proportion of risk will be minimum to minimum. So the construction of portfolio is totally depends upon the attitude of investors towards the risk. If some investors want to maximize their risk, but they do not want to take much risk, then again, portfolio manager will offer particular kind of securities to them. On the basis of that, they are able to enhance their overall return by taking the nominal risk in the market. So main concept behind Markowitz model, that is to diversified your overall risk by investing by investing in a portfolio. Markowitz do not suggest that investment in a single security, but he gives the thought that when investor rationally select the security and construct the portfolio, then definitely investor is able to maximize the return by taking the nominal risk. Now let's read whatever is written in your book and in your slide, that it is widely accepted fact that holding two stocks is less risky proportions than holding one stock. For instance, holding stocks from different industry companies is better and safe than investing the total fund on a single company's stock. Definitely, when investors select different industries for their investment, then investor is able to enhance their overall risk. Means investor is able to control their risk and tries to maximize their overall return. But the task of constructing an optimum portfolio is very difficult. Yes, but obvious. It is not very much easy that we are going to select some securities and we are going to construct the portfolio and we are able to reduce the risk. Here, the major task from the side of investor is the selection of proper security with the rational analysis. And this is possible with the help of Markowitz model. Because as a layman, we are quite unaware about the market moves. We are not able to get the proper idea that how security will react on the particular situation. So, Markowitz model, with the help of Markowitz model, we are able to maximize our return and minimize our risk. So there is a relationship between risk and return. As we already know that higher the risk, higher will be the return. Lower the risk, then lower will be the return. So now this is the risk and return relationship. But with the help of Markowitz model, with the help of the rational decision, an investor is able to maximize their return by taking the moderate risk. It is not always possible that we are taking the higher risk and we are getting the higher return. But sometimes investor is able to maximize the return by taking only moderate risk. So this risk and return relationship is properly analyzed by the Markowitz, and on the basis of that analysis, he gives two formula to the investors for the portfolio construction. That is portfolio return and portfolio risk. that we already discussed in our last session. Now, there are few assumptions of this model. Then one by one we are going to discuss this. First one, each investment alternative is considered as being represented by a probability distribution of expected return over some holding period. Whatever investment option is going to be selected by an investor, it is totally based upon the probability distribution. And when the simple probability distribution is going to be there in the selection of that particular avenue, at that time the investor is going to judge the expected return of that selected avenue for the specific period of time. So simply, whatever security is selected by investors, we are going to calculate the return of that particular security for the selection option. Then after second one, investors try to maximize one period expected utility, and their utility curves show diminishing marginal utility of wealth. But obvious, investors try to maximize their return over a period of time. They do not want to continue with the same return that their security provides for a longest period of time. They want a growth in their return aspects. So if we are talking about the marginal utility means when you are going to change your selected option, means whatever securities that are selected by the investor, if investor is going to change the selection criteria, and if investor added a new security, then definitely there must be increase in their expected return. So that's the Markowitz model all about. Means when you are going to change your portfolio, when you are going to add some new security for your investment purpose, so at that same time your return will increase definitely. If you will continue with the same return that you are already getting, then there is no need to select that one additional security for the construction of the portfolio. So here, investor need to focus on the marginal utility criteria for adding any additional security in the portfolio. Then after third point, investors' estimation or investor estimated risk of the portfolio based on the variability of expected return. Now there are few variables that directly affects the risk perception of investors' portfolio. So here we are going to focus on that variables that directly affects the risk criteria of our portfolio. If the variables are external and if the variability of the variables are really very strong, then we are not able to minimize the risk because it is out of control. So we need to think about the variance or the variables through which the expected return is going to be justified. Then after fourth one, that is investment decision is exclusively based on two things. The first one, that is expected return that the security provides to each and every investor in a proper manner. And the second one, that is variance of return. Variance means the level of risk which is attached with the particular security. So here, investor will focus on this group in this criteria in a proper manner. And then after, the rational decision is going to be taken by the investor for the selection of securities of portfolio. Then after, the next assumption is investor prefer higher return to lower return for a given level of risk. But obvious, whatever the level of risk, the investors will get the return on the basis of risk which is taken by the investors. So it's all about the explanation of Markowitz model. Yes, try to understand the solution which is given to you on the page number 94. So today try your hand on the illustration which is given, the illustration of Markowitz model on the page number 94. And in the next session, we are going to understand the charts which explain the relation of risk and return on the page number 98 and 99. Again, make my words, Markowitz model is really very important for your examination. If Markowitz model is there, then first and foremostly you are going to give the explanation of expected return, expected risk. Then after, the relationship between risk and return. Then after, you are going to explain the portfolio diversification, that how portfolio diversification gives benefits to the investors. Then after, the assumptions of Markowitz model, and later on you will conclude your answer with the formula which we already discussed in our last session. So it's all about Markowitz model.